Dr. R. S. Maurya, helping you to get a better understanding of English language and also enable you to speak concisely, effectively and fluently in a certain situation. तो गाइस, आज हम अलग चीज़ आपको बताने जा रहे हैं और ये बताने जा रहे हैं कि कैसे आप सेमिनार में बोलते हैं। देखिए, ये सेमिनार में बोलना तो बड़ी ऊंची चीज़ होती है, लेकिन फिर भी ये जो हमने मंच तैयार किया है स्पोकन इंग्लिश में, इसमें सिर्फ यही नहीं बताना है कि खाना खाया कि नहीं, कहाँ जा रहे हो, इधर आओ उधर आओ, ये सब चीज़ नहीं। आवर स्पोकन इंग्लिश क्लास इज़ क्वाइट डिफरेंट फ्रॉम अदर्स। तो गाइज, हम बिना डिले किए हुए आपको एक मॉडल प्रस्तुत करेंगे कि कैसे जो है ये लेक्चर दिया जाता है, किसमें, सेमिनार में। सेमिनार में लेक्चर देने का मतलब होता है कि आप अपने को एग्जास्ट करें, आप वैल्यूएबल चीज़ जो है बताएं और रिलेट करें कि कैसे चीज़ें वो रिलेट करती है। जैसे फॉर एग्जांपल, हमने न्यू एजुकेशन पॉलिसी पर हमने आज आपको बात करनी है। जैसे मैं सेमिनार में हूँ तो कैसे, किस तरह से बात करूँगा। तो अब यहाँ से सेमिनार शुरू होता है। तो मिस्टर चेयरमैन, प्रोफेसर रंजीत सिन्हा, हेड डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ एजुकेशन, प्रेजेंट डिग्निटरीज, हेड्स ऑफ द रिस्पेक्टिव डिपार्टमेंट्स, कलीग्स एंड माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इट्स माय प्राउड प्लेजर टू गेट एन अपॉर्चुनिटी टू से समथिंग ऑन न्यू एजुकेशन पॉलिसी। ऑल्दो इट इज नॉट क्लियर, बट लेट अस डिस्कस एंड आई एम हियर टू डायलेट समथिंग ऑन न्यू एजुकेशन पॉलिसी। So let us say what new education policy says. New education policy, that is a 2020, and while introducing new education policy, Mr. President Narendra Modi was so much excited and overwhelmed that he said to that extent that it will prove a game changer in the field of education. So he was very hopeful, because the education minister Ramesh Pokhariyal advised the schools and colleges and universities to open a debate, hold seminars and symposium on new education policy 2020, just to make the people convinced what the new education policy is, and let it be known to everyone. Again, Dr. Kasturi Nandan, the man who has taken a lot of pain to study, research and observation, and he had gone to the very depths of research and findings, and got something to say to you. After a year of debate and discussions, the NEP, National Education Policy, has been introduced in the system of Indian education. The content and the intent of the new education policy and uniformity in schools and colleges, uniformity in syllabus, uniformity in admission, examination and results, for all that national education policy is responsible for. So that kind of policy this time has been framed, and thoroughly framed to cover the global education as well. It is student-centric and seen from the point of view of the students. It is focused on activity based on education. The purpose and philosophy behind it is to create a digital and enlightened and ignited mind. That mind may go for inquiry, inquiring mind, and innovative mind, and capable of critical thinking and intelligent mapping. So the mind which stands to global challenges, a man speaking to man of the world. So learning is a scientific environment. New education policy 2020 aims to connect talent and technology together. No hidden knowledge remains outside. So information and technology will enable the students' areas, all knowledge and all kinds of knowledge in no time. We are able to grasp and find all sorts of knowledge present in our jurisdiction. So this is because of IT. Credit system is another concept that syllabus is framed and number of credit will be given to each program. The students will be judged on the credit they have earned in the examination so far. If they have good in earning credit, they will be allotted good marks. If not, they will be asked to earn required credits. That credit system you already know, that our education syllabus has been tuned according to the credit. This much credit has been given to this much topic, and the student has to earn the credit, and this will be there. That is one thing. Another thing is multiple entities and existence, that student's freedom is there, student's centric is there, that students can take admission, and if he finds some inconvenient, or he is posted somewhere, or accidentally got job, so he can restart his syllabus. So that provision is already there. That is called entrance and multiple entrance and existence. As many time you can come to college as you like, take admission as you like, leave it, and then again come and retake admission, and then again go. So this kind of system is there, and the in different skills oriented syllabus will be attached to the right from the school to the college and university. Graduation has diploma certificate. Yes, that certificate is there. Degree, diploma, certificates is there. MPhil is omitted, you all know, and the 4 years degree course has been there, and after 75% marks you will be allowed to go for research, and there also entrance examination may be there. Entrance examination as graduate level is also there. At the time of entrance is also there. It is on a state level as well as the central level. So central university has already done their job, and students are taking admission on the basis of the entrance examination, central entrance examination. So yes, this is one point. Dignity of teacher would be retained. Emphasis has been given that good teacher should serve, and their dignity should be retained. Good resources will help to upgrade the college or universities. So resources, quality of resources, quality of teachings would definitely will enhance the the standard of education in country. Future of the countries go through the NAC, good grades. NAC will help you, the colleges, UGC fund and all these things. Status of autonomy is there, that autonomy will be given to the colleges or the institution who got consistently 3 times good grades. So that was there, and the last stage is autonomy of the institution. So this is what is the short discussion on new education policy. So guys, I have just given a short lecture on how to understand this new education policy. Now my aim is to hold you for this kind, because seminar is also a part of curricular activities. Many colleges have a seminar, even the schools have seminar, and the dignitaries would come and you have to speak. So seminar is of course very academic program that is launched during your school, college or university time, and student get profit and delight meeting students, good students who are taking part, and the good professors who are to teach them how to take part in seminar. So guys, this is all about that, and now we'll again take one more model of seminar that is on the same topic, analysis of new education policy. So that's all for today. So meet you next day. Thank you.